Hey, good morning, everyone. It is Saturday, and today we are moving for our hips. And so we'll get started in a child's pose, just as everyone's kind of logging in. And so much light for you this Saturday morning. It's a beautiful sunny day here in Calgary, and I hope wherever you are, there is sunshine. And if there's no sun yet, know that we can create our own light with movement. Movement has such a way of bringing positive energy, creating endorphins, and so as we start to move, be open to the power that you have to create that light. And as I came up to get set up for class, I thought about the importance of staying in the moment, being present for ourselves and our family, our friends, and so I know today we'll take time to connect with people that we love, and there's no better place that we can set a really positive intent as we start to move through your practice. Be open to receiving any light, any love, any scent of joy that will help you move forward. And I've made a really fun playlist for us to get to start move. So again, we are in child's pose, and just start to take inventory of your body, scan through. Start at the fingertips, so feel the palms pressing into the mat here. And then the elbows will start to lift off the mat. The arms are charging up. Again, wherever you are, whether you've done your morning walk already or just rolling out of bed, landing on your mat, take a deep breath in and set an intention. On your exhale, let it start to manifest. In the mind, in your body, and most importantly, in your heart. On your next breath, we come up into our tabletop and gaze down between the thumbs. And we're starting off with some Bill Withers to give a tribute to him. So let's get moving when you're ready. Press into your toes. Send your hips up to the sky, landing into your first down dog. Beautiful. And normally we pedal out our legs, but today we'll bend the knees lightly and then send the heels down to the mat. Bent. And then extend length through the backside of your legs. So bent and send up. And bent. Send up. Two more. Last one. And both heels drawing towards the mat. Think about that length, that energy. We breathe in for this moment. Bend the knees, look forward, step hop float to the top. Halfway lift and fold. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, fold through center. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step hop back to your high plank. Take a moment to scan through the body. And we take inventory so that as we move, we can tap in to our own authentic power. And if there's any modifications, any movements that you know that you want to make so that the practice be everything that you need it to be for today, move authentically. Listen to your body, honor it. Deep breath in, exhale, lower through, chaturanga. Upward facing dog, exhale, down dog. Go bend the knees, look forward, step hop float to the top, halfway lift and fold, rise up, reach up and fold, halfway lift, plant your hands, step hop back, high plank, one breath, exhale, we flow, upward facing dog and down, big toes to touch, extend that right leg nice and long. And let yourself land in here. We have nothing to compare. It is about being in the moment this morning or this afternoon if you're on the east. In the moment is about landing where you are and celebrating it. Step foot, right foot through. Drop the left knee down. Hands reach up. Small little back bend. Hands come back to the... Tuck the toes, set back high plank, lower through, Upward facing dog.
Exhale, down dog. Big toes to touch. Left leg lifts. Gazing forward, step it through. Right knee comes down. Inhale, sweep the hands up.
Beautiful little tribute. Thank you for moving here, bringing the energy, bringing that light.
Hands come back to the mat. Step back to your high plank. Lower through.
Upward facing dog.
And down. Bending knees, look forward, step hopper, float your feet to the top. Halfway lift and fold. Inhale.
Sink down into your chair pose. Shoulders roll back, them softening down your spine. Heart's nice and open. Tap into our hips, we pulse, pulse. Hands come to heart center, keep pulsing. For five, four, three, two, and hold. Reach up and forward fold.
Plant your hands as we cycle through vinyasa.
Inhale your intentions, open hearted.
Exhale, down dog. Big toes to touch, right leg reaches up. Looking forward, step it through. We stay in low runner's lunge. Gaze down at that left hip. Opening it up, giving it that warmth, that light.
Inhale, reach, hands up. Hands coming back through heart center. And think about charging up the spine here. We pulse left knee. Down, up, down, up. In today's practice, we got about 40 minutes of movement. Last 20, we get into some really nice deep hip poses. So we're warming up right now. We're bringing that heat. For five, four, three, two, and hold it. Reach up. Extend that length. Small little back bend.
Hands come back down. Step back to your high plank. Hold high plank. Knees to pulse down. Pulse, pulse, pulse. For three, two, and one. Cycle through vinyasa or go right into your down dog. You choose. Big toes to touch, left leg lifts, gaze forward, step it through, look at the leg, open up the right hip, when you're ready, sweep both hands up.
I had a lot of fun making this list. I was thinking, growing up, every Saturday we kind of put on some good tunes and clean the house. Hands come down to heart center, so if you're cleaning your house today, the playlist is public. Pulse the right leg here. Down, down. For five, four, three, two, hold. Charge up. Extend hands to the sky. Deep breath in.
Cycle through to the mat, step back, high plank, hold. Pulse, knees down, pulse, pulse. For three, two, hold. Straighten out, right hand taps the left shoulder, then switch, right, left, right, left. You can go at your own pace. So you know what you want this morning. If you're moving a little faster, you have that energy, or take it down. For three, two, hold. Deep breath in, cycle through. Down dog. Bend the knees, look forward, step hop float to the dump. Halfway lift and fold. Reach up. Sink down here. Hands move to heart center. Shoulders roll. Let's get nice and warm. Back to those pulses. Down, down. And keep all four corners of your foot nice and engaged. Press the knees together here. Supercharge. For five, four, three, two, hold. And keep pressing those legs together. Squeeze. For three, two, and one. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step hop back. Deep breath in, we exhale and move. And always aligning your breath with movement again at your home. Move at your own pace, honor your body. Take moments for rest and water. Big toes to touch. Right leg lifts. Bend the right knee, stack your hips open. Think about checking in here. Our heart rate's quite elevated. We brought warmth, energy, light. You come back to that intent, that word, thought, whatever's inspiring your movement. We fill up for the series. Straighten the leg, look forward, step the right foot through. Land in the left heel. Warrior one, both hands reach up to the sky. Sink into it. Gazes forward, beautiful. And warrior one, such a beautiful posture. When we land into it, I have two words that come to mind. I think about this calm energy. Upper body's nice and open. There's this lightness in our upper body. But as we start to sink through to the power of our legs, we think about our courage, our fierce energy, and we ground it in through the heels. And there's this calm energy up top and this fierce courage sinking through, grounding you. In this moment, in uncertainty, we lift up, we open up into warrior two. Pivot your toes. Left toes are facing that left side. Gaze comes forward, arms parallel to the mat. Beautiful opening running through that right hip. Taking that right elbow down to the right knee, extend left hand up to the sky. Gaze follows that left hand. Hold here for three, two, and one. Lead with that left hand, come up, move with control, straighten that right leg, then hinge, reach forward. Right hand comes down, left hand comes back up. And we charge back in for three deep breaths. We think about that calm energy in the upper body and that courage running through our legs. Leading with the left hand, come up, sink back to your warrior two. Sweep forward into crescent lunge. So just pivot those left toes to the mat, hands reach up now. We've been here before, hands to heart center. Hinge forward. Sort of ignite that spine. Energy is now moving from those roots into the legs, now up through the arms. If you want, you can reach them forward here. Hold for three, two. Keep pressing into those left toes. Hands come down. Step back to your high plank. Take a deep breath and cycle through with your exhale. Big toes to touch, left leg now lifts. Bend the knee, open up the hips. Straightening it out, step through. Warrior one, and we get grounded on this left side, and we take a moment again to tune in to that calm energy kind of washing over through from your crown to your heart. You sink down into your courage, that strength, that energy. Breathe.
opening up to your warrior two. Just pivot the toes lightly, gaze forward, sink into the heels, into your side angle right away. Left elbow to your left knee, right hand reaches up to the sky. Roll the shoulders back again. Calm energy, upper body, open. Lead with that right hand, come up, straighten the leg, hinge forward. Left hand comes back down, right hand reaches back up. And think about the line here from your right fingertips to your left. And pressing lightly into your left leg to allow for an openness. Lead with right hand, come up, sink down. And tricky transition, and if you fall out, please have fun with it. Sweep that right hand forward, come onto your right toes. We land back in crescent lunge, hands back to heart center. Lunge forward, you can start to charge up your spine here. We think about your posture, this energy moving through your vertebrae. We hinge forward, and if you're feeling it, hands to reach with you. And long line of energy here from fingertips right through to your right toes. Keep charging it up. Breathe for 5, 4, 3, 2, touchdown. Step back here. Hold high plank. Take a breath. Reset. Reconnect. On your exhale, cycle through. Big toes to touch, right leg lifts up, bend the knee. Now you know yourself best here. If you enjoy this kind of hip opener, stay here. If you want to move through a flip dog, guide that right foot all the way over, flip, press the hips up, this beautiful arch into your spine. Now we think about how our energy is moving through that vertebrae. We are in such an open space. Move back through, three-legged dog. Gaze forward. Take the right knee into your chest and hold. Hold it here. Press into the hands. For 3, 2, step that foot through. Land into it. And I know I'm doing a lot of lunges here today, but we're tapping into our hips so that they're nice and warm. Hands come back up. Beautiful. Take them into cactus arms. We pulse into the left leg, come down and up. Down, up. And if you have weights at home, you can grab them here, kind of move with them. If you're not moving with weights and you just want to have the upper body moving a little bit, grooving with the music, for 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold. Here's the transition. Hands come down to the mat. We press into that right foot. Left leg's gonna come up. It seems like we're setting up for a standing split, but we're gonna come into our squats here. So that left knee comes behind the right, and we slowly go down and up, down and down. Ho. Can we get 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold here. Gaze down at the knee. Send back into that lunge. Left foot comes down. Hold here. When you're ready, right foot comes back. We hold plank. Through the instrumental break, it felt appropriate. If you want to dance and sway a little bit here, keep drawing that energy in. Fill your core. Let it expand for 3, 2, 1. Cycle through. Upward dog. And down.
Big toes touch, we move right to the left side. Bend the knee. Moving with your breath. And you choose to flip or you choose to stay. And land where you want to be. When you're ready, make that choice. Fill up, feel that beautiful arch in your back. If you're staying in your three-legged dog, think about guiding your heel towards your hip some more. We meet back in our three-legged dog. Cycle back through. Step through for the lunge. Rock into your right toes. When you're ready, both hands up. And charge up. Hands to heart center or cactus arm, whatever you're feeling here. Down, down. Align with your breath, move with your breath. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, reach up and we come down, plant into the left side, the transition, ground into it when you're ready. Right leg reaches up. Right knee comes behind the left and we go down. And up, down, and up. And it's okay if that heel comes up off the ground lightly. For 3, 2, last one, we got this. Press up, stretch it out. We transition back, right toes touch, lunge. Hold the lunge. Take a moment for your hips to breathe. Step back, high plank. Deep breath in, we move with breath. Cycle through a vinyasa. Upward facing dog. Exhale down. Big toes touch, right leg reaches up. We cycle through. Right foot to plant, we windmill open up for warrior two. Take 5 breaths in warrior two. Get into those heels. Connect into your courage. When we connect with our courage, we tap into that calm energy. We move forward with fierce, with certainty, conviction and clarity. Sink into it. Whatever is resonating with you, take it. When you're ready, straighten up. I'm gonna just turn heel lightly. So you're staying in your warrior two. Straighten up and then the toes kind of face the same direction. They're gonna come out slightly. Heels are in. We're moving into goddess squats. I'll turn around when we get going here. But come down as deep as you can and we pulse. Down, 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 down. Beautiful. Now for 3, 2, hold it. Pop that right heel. This is my favorite latest move. Ground into the left. Now dip, dip. Whew. For 3, 2, hold it. Switch. Left heel pops. Grounding into the right. Here we go. Dip, dip. For 3, 2, and 1, hold. Ground both heels, press through, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Again, we are wide-legged in this forward fold. Let your head shake out. From here, we're just gonna walk our hands forward to the top of the mat. Now your right leg steps back here. We cycle through. Upward facing dog or cobras. Beautiful, big toes to touch. Left leg lifts up. We step it through, warrior two, left side, windmill open up. Beautiful. The song speaks to my soul. Because I know for certain, this is a little bit of a darker time.
But when we take our courage, we take our calm energy, we find light. And in the darkest of times, that light needs to be there for us, for our family, for our friends. Straighten up. We come into our pulses here. So toes, feet are about that width distance. Toes out, heels in. Come down into your squat. Shoulders roll back. However you want to open up here, we pulse into our hips. Down, down. You want to sing at home? Sing it. It's gonna be alright. And I'll repeat that. Our courage in times that we feel anxious and worried and etc. strengthens us. We breathe in and we feel with that courage a sense of calmness that brings light for this darkness. Hold it, right heel pops and left, focus. Five, four, three, two, hold it, pop opposite, go, right heel. In the moment, how much do you love these hips? For three, two, hold it, both heels stretch up, we forward fold, nice wide-legged forward fold. Let your heads go, spine relaxes. You can feel the movement here from your sit bones. Any tightness, any tension that you're holding into your hips. And think about tapping into it and giving yourself permission to let it go. Again, we are in a really warm space. We've tapped in with a lot of positive words. Movement that is manifesting positivity. Not only in our body, but in our minds. So whatever comes to you right now, just take it. On your exhale, let it resonate. We slowly rise up. Nice flat back here. Shoulders roll. Pivot all the toes towards the top of your mat. We step forward. We take forward of the mat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step, hop back, high plank. Lower through. Take back, down dog. Coming onto your hands and knees. Nice tabletop. A few bird dogs. Bird dogs are so good for our stabilizing muscles. I like to mix in some movement that is really friendly for postpartum or anyone that's just working on building up core. And this is a really effective way to move and build a lot of power in a really calm way. When you're ready, right leg kicks back, sends back, left arm reaches forward. And it's about moving with integrity, moving with our mind and being in the moment. So we think about that reach, we move with purpose, we exhale. Take it in and forward and in. Reach. And you could be adding in the smallest little pulse to tap into the complementing muscles here through the legs, through the shoulders, getting into your low back. For three. In two, last one, hold. From here, that left hand comes back down, we keep the right leg elevated. If you want to turn this into a modified plank, turn that right hand up to the sky here. Now, if you're feeling super energized and you want to come into that full side plank, you do you. This is such a nice, nice hip opener. Beautiful alignment. Hear those melodies of Nora Jones. For three, two,
and take it back. Now that right leg stays lifted, we take it down lightly, open up, fire hydrant, hold. Think about pressing equal weight into the hands. If you can, lift the knee a little bit more. Small little circles here. Again, mindful movement. Small and effective. Switch directions. For three, two, and hold. Take it down. All right, left side, left leg kicks back. Nice straight line. Right arm forward, deep breath in. Exhale, take it through. Stay with the breath. Continue to move. Tapping into whatever's speaking to you right now. Your power, your courage. Or maybe that really calm energy. You have that light. You know how you're going to move forward and inspire. How you're going to shine that light on a little bit of darkness. For two. Last one. Reach. Right hand comes down slowly. Here we transition for that side plank. So start to roll into that right knee. If you're feeling it, left hand reaches up. And you can follow the gaze up to that left hand. If you want to take that full side plank, please move in a way that speaks to you. Keep that left foot charged up. Inner thighs start to shake. Breathe in. That courage, that fierce energy holds you stable, brings confidence. For three, two, we move slowly. Left leg stays lifted, it comes down lightly, and then opens up. Hold, get into that alignment, gazes down at your thumbs, small little circles. Totally unexpected that my mom's doing this in Northern Ontario, and a lot of these songs were songs that she and my dad introduced me to. Move in the opposite direction. This is my dad's and I's father-daughter dance at our wedding. For three, two, and one, slowly with control, bring it back. And the next one is for my mom. And so it's amazing how music can really tap in and keep us inspired, keep us feeling good. So if there's songs that you want to even add to your playlist, I'll make this collaborative so you can add in your own kind of jukebox weekend playlist. Tuck your toes in, send your hips high. Beautiful. Let's cycle through here. Come back, high plank. Let's do a few vinyasas here. High plank, lower through. Two more, high plank, low. Again, modify, come onto your knees here, do a cobra. It is beautiful to modify, to honor your body. Last one. Bend your knees, look forward, step hop, float your feet to the top of the mat. Now we stay for a nice wide-legged stance here. Gonna grab opposite elbows. Let your head be heavy. Feel the movement through the spine. Too good not to turn it up. Shake it out.
Children get older.
All right, from here, we're gonna move into gorilla. Really tap into some deep, deep tissues in our hips and our low back. Lift your toes so that just your heels stay connected, then sneak your hands right underneath your feet and like really press into them. Let your head stay heavy. Bend your knees as much as it feels right for you. And then over time, you start to kind of straighten. This is such a nice release, and I know a lot of us are working from home. We might be on our phones and computers more than usual, so stretch out the palms, all the little muscles in our hands. Slowly coming off the feet, we slowly roll up to stand.
Reach up. Sink down into your hips, chair pose. Hands to heart center. We twist and rinse. We are in such a nice warm space right now to effectively twist and detox energy from our vital organs. So if you want to hook that elbow onto your right knee, you can hook it or keep it up. And breathe in through the twist. Press the palms together if you're staying elevated. Stay into it. Two more. On your next inhale, we move back through center. Hold it. Hands reach forward. We got this. Keep sinking, sinking. Hands come down, step back, high plank, hold high plank. Sway the hips side to side. In small movements here, we're keeping the alignment of our spine for 3, 2, and 1. Back through center, cycle through vinyasa. Upward facing dog. Exhale down. Bend the knees, look forward. Step hop forward. Halfway lift. Fold. Inhale, reach. Come back through that heart center. Press the palms together. And we ignite this energy at the core, where that courage and where that calmness meets. Is at your center, what's holding you. Take a deep breath, twist it through, and count. Deep, deep breaths, and you hook or you elevate. Keep the palms pressing together here. Keep the knees connected. Keep dropping your heels. In the last few moments, we have all this heat, all this warmth, that light. We are gonna take it and then give permission to our hips to really open up. Last 3, 2, back center. Reach up, sink down. I'm not gonna forget this transition. Reach forward, keep going down, and down, and down. Lower than you even think you could. Hands touch, step back, hold, sway it out. For 3, 2, and 1, come back center, cycle, up dog, cobras, and down dog. Come onto your knees, send back into a child's pose here. Wide-legged, closed-legged, the legs can even be slightly apart. Whatever feels right for you as you come down. And acknowledge your heart beating here. All your effort, all your hard work,
Day in, I will remind you to acknowledge yourself for showing up, for making these choices to breathe and move positivity. Even in those moments that it's dark, without a doubt, but we make such positive choices to lead ourselves, to lead others, and to share our light. We come back up. We're gonna do some nice pigeon poses here, so hips high. And if pigeon pose isn't a part of your practice for whatever reason, if you're expecting or this is tight, hard on your knees, I'll modify you. But if you are in your pigeon, let's take the right knee to your right wrist, right heel over to that left hip, and I create a really nice diagonal here. Take a moment to peek behind your left leg, make sure it's nice and long, and then we're gonna come right into it. Enough back, enough core. Let's get right into our hips. And so if you have a block or a bolster at home and you wanna kind of really get into it here, didn't realize, Mom, but two songs back to back. Take a deep breath. Send that breath and give your right hip permission to open up. And maybe the next 20 breaths will be for the right hip. Or maybe you'll start to see how this pigeon pose is marinating in your body, kind of opening up muscles through the side. Just one breath at a time. Again, the moment we come into pigeon, we kind of feel that anchor in the presence. And if we can, relax the forehead as much as you can. And if you're feeling it, just notice the direction that you are feeling it and where are the sensations. Are they moving down your leg or up through your side bodies? And it's amazing how these postures can speak to us. They can remind us where we need a little bit of light, a little bit of warmth, and a big reminder to give yourself permission to relax, to let it go. Last two breaths. Making them count, making them be 100% for you. You can never look at me. I am old, but I'm happy. Press into the hands. And we come out of it just as we came in. So press into the palms. Lift up, send the right leg back. If it feels good, lift it, shake it, pedal out your legs. If you want vinyasa, whenever you're ready, we move into the left side. Left leg lifts, take it through, left knee to your left wrist. That right leg's nice and long. Beautiful. You can even check back behind the shoulder. Make sure it is long and lengthened. You can feel that warmth in your hip. Feel any tightness in your glute and then kind of melt into it. I'm going to dim down the music. Had to turn it up on landslide. That song kind of followed me my whole life. I feel if I were to make like a playlist of my life, it would be one of those songs that kind of repeats itself throughout. And so when we land onto the left side, those first few breaths can be intense. You can feel years of hard work. You can feel all your effort from January to kind of March 14th. At Hot Shop, we had literally just finished a
30-day challenge, and then kind of made a big shift with how we decided to move. And so if you think about all your efforts, all your hard work from the beginning of January to these moments where we are staying at home, self-isolating, and you think about taking this time to check in and observe the body, to be with our breath and acknowledge what's working for us and maybe what we need to switch up. So again, just bring awareness in your body. If you are feeling that movement, that sensation go down into your glutes, down into the legs, or if it's going through your upper body, let your shoulders relax, let your head go. And breathe the deepest breaths. Remember, we're taking that courage and that calmness, bringing it to the roots of who we are and letting our light shine onto this darkness. And maybe you are that super light that has a little bit more to give. Think about the reach that you have. And you have been called to inspire and share that light, because it's not in everyone, and we know, because you are here, that it is a daily effort. It is something that we continue to make a choice, and how blessed we are to have this practice, this way of moving and being. And I'm grateful for your time, for your energy. So we will slowly come up out of the left side. We will stay down on our mats here just by kind of shifting onto the left hip. Swing that right leg forward. We will flush through a nice forward fold. So hands on the knees, shoulders roll back. We lift with length. Lift. Feel that light deep in the core, your strength, your values, your authenticity. Exhale, forward fold. And so if that block, that bolster, the pillow, blankets are by, set yourself up. And this comes back now, evening out the hips, getting into your glutes. And maybe you move your support systems away a little bit further so you can come down. And in this forward fold, if it feels good to have your hands grounded, ground them. If you are calling for energy from the earth, let it move through you. Know and take what any energy you feel will support and encourage you. And again, maybe you're that super light. You open up and you have more to give. We take a deep breath in. On your exhales, we share. Slowly roll up. Take your time. I'll let your spine realign, your shoulders, neck, and head come up. Beautiful. And then just a really complimenting way to do that pigeon pose, or get into the pigeon pose even deeper, is that deer pose. So as we set up for that, this is one that we can really do kind of when we're reading a book or playing with our kids, taking a moment to sit sit on the ground instead and get into this one. So that right leg is parallel with the front of the mat, left leg is parallel with the side, shoulders roll back. We start with a neutral position, we lift, and then we twist. We take our gaze over to that right side. We come down slowly.
and we come on to that support, that block, the bolster. We think about letting the belly relax onto the leg. You come down as low as you can here. And so this one, though it's complementing for a pigeon, it does get into different muscles. You'll feel that whole right side of your leg, the outer thigh, kind of rolling into the mat here. So you can take your empowered breath, all your effort, all that warmth from your practice, and think about grounding it here. We have a tendency of holding energy in our hips. And that energy can be physical tightness from our lifestyle. It can also be emotional energy. So as we kind of wind down, we tap in. We have these awarenesses and we let our breath resonate in any positive way for you. Last breath on the side. We slowly press up. We stay in this posture. That left leg is going to swing forward. Beautiful. So that we are forward like this. Sean does this one and I love it. If you don't follow Sean, he's in my stories often. Follow him this week. We'll be teaching on Wednesday. So we start with lift length. We hinge over towards that right knee. And then we bend towards the left foot. So you can do whatever you want here with that right hand. But just think about kind of keeping that heart space nice and open. And so when we move through our pigeon pose, and I talked about that energy moving up through your side body, it's amazing how tightness in our hips can start to affect our sides, the spine. So this is a really beautiful pose to kind of complement all of that warmth and movement. If it helps, even pressing into your toes and then moving you deeper. On your inhale, come up. Gaze forward. We take that left foot in. Right leg switches out. Move the blocks, bolsters, and set up. All these hips. Inhale, reach, move, forward fold, and come down onto that block, that bolster. But again, think about grounding here into that whole left leg, that outer thigh, the glutes, and roll into it. Take a deep breath. And on that exhale, it's that permission. Again, let go. Let go of any tightness, any tension, any obstacles. Anything that you've taken on, that you are assessing as no longer serving you. Inhale and let it go. And a few breaths, again, this is complementing our all of our effort in our pigeon, kind of giving a last moment to release from our glutes. In that tightness you might have felt in your pigeon pose, if you're holding on to tension in your glutes, your low back, and again, give yourself permission to let it go. We are rolling into this beautiful Saturday, and I want you feeling all that energy. We slowly come up. Again, from here, that right leg's gonna swing forward. And we open up now that side body. And we start sitting with length, shoulders roll back, we lift length. Then we turn to that left leg. And then we hinge to that right. Again, hand stays nice and open. Shoulders roll back. Think about breathing into that side body. And so maybe you felt it in your pigeon. There was that tightness kind of shooting up your spine. Take deep, deep breaths. Maybe you feel it on your exhales. Maybe you feel the muscles. And that's how connected you are right now to yourself. Is that you feel the smallest, smallest openings happening. And that is because you made the choice to move, to be on your mat, to be in service for yourself. Coming back up slowly. From here, we take our gaze forward, lengthen both legs, given enough time. I'm gonna make sure our shavasana and our closing postures are all in this hour. So we'll roll back. Again, if you have blocks or bolsters or anything at home to do a lymphatic drain, one of my favorites, and I think that's a Julie's favorites as well. So when you do this later, finish off with a nice lymphatic drain, come back, tilt your hips up so that block comes to your low back, legs reach up to the sky. If you want, include the arms. If not, have the arms in a cactus pose or any posture that feels good. Here we elevate the hips. We are draining the body, our lymphatic system, replenishing energy back from the heart space, from the lungs. And while we're doing all those internal things, we take a moment to scan the body. And you stay here as long as you'd like, and when you are ready to move into your shavasana, move slowly, find that horizontal, but until you feel like you've balanced your own energy, maybe it's 10 breaths or 15, tap into the power of your breath. And we think about that analogy today that we separated our body in half, and that upper body is that calm energy, that light, open heart, open mind. And the roots down through the legs were that courage, that strength, that stability. And it's all coming through center right now. And when that calmness and that courage meet, it creates such a light. And that light is within you. And when you take the time to build light into your life, your body, to your being, everyone around you will be inspired. They will gravitate to you. And you think about the power of that. And it's not necessarily about a number or quantifying it. It is a feeling, that courage and that calmness combine. When you are ready to transition into your shavasana, I got a beautiful note last Saturday that one of my friends fell asleep after the practice and had a little nap on her mat. And it's just like, that stuff always used to happen in studio, and I'm so grateful that you have it in the comfort of your home. So even if you do doze off, please do. Give yourself a little bit more time. Scan the body. Again, for your meditation, beyond this minute and a half, if you can keep focusing on those two parts combining, that calmness coming from the mind and heart, and that strength coming from the legs, the roots, your values, who you are, and how when they meet, they create light. And that light is supporting everyone around you, your family, your friends, and by choosing for movement, for taking time for your mind, body, and soul, you'll be able to continue to show up and inspire. And so I'm humbled and I'm grateful to be a part of your journey, a part of your meditation, a part of this experience. Though it may feel dark at times, we have a lot of light to share, and it means so much to me to connect. So continue to scan the body, have awareness. Maybe we're tapping into that calmness a little bit more. Maybe you need it. Or maybe it's taking that courage. And what courage is energy and acknowledgement that there is something that is scaring us, something that is real happening, and we are deciding to show up with that calmness. There be light. And beautiful practice. Thank you so much for sharing your time, your energy. Namaste.